tribe as well. I do appreciate your viewership, whatever time you happen to be listening to this. I just got off from work. I'm in the park right now. Man, oh man, oh man. This field getting egged up today. Damn. Can we have a little prayer for the brother? Whew. Bless this man.
Samazamala.
It's crazy. Because it's the same guy that didn't have no problem putting out videos calling sisters ratchet and hyenas and shit.
And I know he explains it, but to me, everybody backtracks when you get caught. When your hand get caught in the cookie jar, the chip bag, oh, I didn't eat the last cookie, I didn't eat the last chip. Let me explain. That's what I was getting the whole entire time. Now you see this assortment of guys on here. Brother Sanchez, Dookie Face, O'Shea Jackson, and Phil from the Vibe Show. Now, I don't really watch a lot of their content. I may catch some of Dookie Face shit. But to me, it brings up a lot more questions that need to be answered. Like, why do we allow people like this in the cypher? And by cypher, I mean, if you really truly are a pro-black, which I assume you are by listening to this, or are you just looking for drama? Once I get it, you know, it's melanated folks, we love the drama. We love to tell everybody and everybody about that drama. What makes you pro-black? Can you be pro-black, degrading women 1 year, and then because you get a billion donations, the next year you in Africa with African women, now you pro-black. Now you just happen to be the spokesperson for melanated folks in America. Then you got Brother Sanchez, who openly just said, you know, he's dating an Asian woman and he's messing with an Asian woman. Okay, that's cool. Once again, that's neither here nor there. You could date who you want to date. My thing is, why are people like this in our cipher? That's my only question. That's my only question. Also, what makes you pro-black? Because I hear a lot of people on here saying, you know, to be pro-black, you gotta buy black, blah, 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 yada, da, yada, da, da. But then you have these cats right here. He's a coon. I'll say Dookie Face, for sure. He's just an opportunist. Phil. Okay. He said he never was hiding his woman. That's neither there nor there, because I don't watch all his content. I only been watching him for about a year, so maybe he did say that. But the fact that you have to talk so much in defense of this kind of leads me to believe that a lot of people really didn't know what his wife looked like. I know I didn't, because I don't watch his content like that. And like I said, I barely just started watching Brother Sanchez content. And then I found out that he was with an Asian woman. What was it, last night? I never really ever heard him ever really dive into his personal life like that on that panel. But my thing is, what's a pro-black? What's the qualifications? What's the template of a pro-black? What makes you pro-black? I want simple answers. Fully answered answers, though. What makes you pro-black? Can I be pro-black and do what Phil is doing, be in the community, which I am, and I spend my own money, I spend my own funds? Oh, another thing. Why don't the people that donate to these people, why don't they ever get shouted out? Like, why don't the people that have to deal with these crackers every damn day go to work for these people to sit on the camera and complain about the crackers while begging for money? But I got to hang out with them because I got to get my money. I got to get my paycheck. I got to work with them. So I have to associate with them. I have to socialize with them because I work with them. Why don't the normal melanated folk, why don't they get any praise? They should be getting the ultimate praise, right? I mean, because we dealing with the most bullshit, correct? Every day I have to go to work. It's bullshit. I want to get 1 billion donations. I want to go to Africa. I want to go to Jamaica. I want to do all that shit. I want people to just donate to me, just to donate. I want to do all that. I mean, I really don't. I'm just saying. You know, it's an expression. I really don't. I don't care. I enjoy working. I just want my own business. And which I'm striving to do. I'm doing it on my own. I don't want any handouts. But why don't... Because what made me come to this was I was on Lisa Cabrera's shit. And somebody said, these cats are doing more for the black community than you're pro-black, quote-unquote. You're pro-black, your favorite pro-black or some shit like that, right? Okay, but I think these cats are getting huge donations. Huge donations. And they're already famous. You can't say anything to these guys, these people, without getting a huge backlash, the fans coming to get you. You know, all the drama we like. Can't say anything, because the littler YouTubers, they can't say shit. The little man gets beat up. But also, the little man fights. So what does the normal people do? The normal people that have to be pro-black. Pro-black is a lifestyle for them. What do? When we face with all this bullshit, having to work for the man all damn day, and come home and you get to see all these YouTubers that are dating other people, get all these damn donations, while you over here working your ass off to the bone for the man. Not begging for donations, not begging for views, not begging for subscribers. What's pro-black? What's pro-black? Shalom, be safe out there.